एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय चैनल श्रीराम एकेडमी, अ प्लेस टू लर्न इन अ सिंपल एंड इजी वे। गाइस, ये जो वीडियो है वो मैंने बनाया है सोलर एनर्जी के ऊपर, दैट इज़ अ टाइप ऑफ रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी। उसके बारे में हम कुछ जानेंगे, ठीक है? तो चलिए, लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द वीडियो, आई वॉन्ट टू से दैट प्लीज़ लाइक एंड शेयर माई वीडियो, वॉच माई वीडियो एंड प्लीज़ सब्सक्राइब। इफ़ यू आर न्यू टू माई चैनल, प्लीज़ सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल। So let's get started. Then what is solar energy? Solar energy is the most abundant energy resource on earth. It can be captured and used in several ways, and as a renewable energy resource is an important part of our clean energy future. Where does all this energy come from? Before going to this topic, some more points about the solar energy. That solar energy comes from the sun and can be captured with various technologies, primarily solar panels. The photovoltaic effect is the mechanism by which silicon solar panels harness the sun's energy and generate electricity. The sun does more than for our planet than just provide light during the daytime. Each particle of sunlight, called a photon, that reaches the earth contains energy that fuels our planet. Solar energy is the ultimate source responsible for all of our weather system and energy sources on earth. And enough solar radiations hits the surface of the earth each day, each hour, to theoretically fill our global energy needs for nearly an entire year. Okay, so moving to our next question, that from where does all of these energies come from? Our sun, like any star in the galaxy, is like a massive nuclear reactor. Deep in the sun's core, nuclear fusion reactions produce massive amounts of energy that radiates outward from the sun's surface and into space in the form of light and heat. Solar power can be harnessed and converted to usable energy using photovoltaics or solar thermal collectors. Although solar energy only accounts for a small amount of overall global energy use, the falling cost of installing solar panels means that more and more people in more places can take advantage of solar energy. Solar is a clean, renewable energy resource and figures to play an important part in the global energy futures. Okay, now next point is that how do we harness solar energy for usable power? Let's see. There are many ways to use energy from the sun. The two main ways to use energy from the sun are photovoltaics and solar thermal capture. Photovoltaics are much more common for smaller scale electricity projects like residential solar panel installation, and solar thermal capture is typically only used for electricity production on massive scales in utility solar installation. In addition to producing electricity, lower temperature variation of solar thermal projects can be used for heating and cooling. Solar is one of the fastest growing and cheapest sources of power in the world and will continue to spread rapidly in the coming years. With solar panel technology improving each year, the economic benefits of solar improve, adding to the environmental perks of choosing a clean, renewable energy source. Now, what is photovoltaic solar energy? Let's have a look about it. That the common way for property owners to take advantage of solar energy is with a photovoltaic PV solar system. With the solar PV system, solar panels convert sunlight right into electricity that can be used immediately, stored in a solar battery or sent to the electric grid for credits on your electric bill. Solar panels convert solar energy into usable electricity through a process known as the photovoltaic effect. Incoming sunlight strikes a semiconductor material, typically silicon, and knocks electron loose, setting them in motion and generating an electric current that can be captured with wiring. This current is known as direct current, that is DC electricity, and must be converted to alternating current, AC electricity, using a solar inverter. This conversion is necessary because the electric grid operates using AC electricity, as do most household electric appliances. Next, what is solar thermal? A second way to use solar energy is to capture the heat from solar radiation directly and use that heat in a variety of ways. Solar thermal energy has a broader range of uses than a photovoltaic system, but using solar thermal energy for electricity generation at a small scale is not as practical as using photovoltaics. There are three general types of solar thermal energy used: low temperature, which is used for heating and cooling; mid temperatures, which is used for heating water; and high temperature, which is used for electrical power generations. Low temperature solar thermal energy systems involve heating and cooling air as a means of climate control. An example of this type of solar energy uses is in passive solar building designs. In properties built for passive solar use, the sun rays are allowed into a living space to heat an area and block when the area needs to be cooled. Mid-temperature solar thermal energy. This system includes solar hot water heating system. In a solar hot water setup, heat from the sun is captured by collectors on your rooftop. This heat is then transferred to the water running through your home's piping, so you don't have to rely on traditional water heating methods such as water heaters powered with oil or gas. Now, talking about the high temperature solar thermal energy. This system are used for generating electricity on a larger scale. In a solar thermal electricity plant, mirrors focus the sun rays on tubes containing a liquid that can hold heat energy well. This heated fluid can then be used to turn water into steam, which then can turn a turbine and generate electricity. This type of technology is often referred to as concentrated solar power. Okay, now what are the advantages of solar energy? First is that it is a renewable energy source. Among all the benefits of solar panels, the most important thing is that solar energy is a truly renewable energy source. It can be harnessed in all areas of the world and is available every day. We cannot run out of solar energy, unlike some of the other sources of energy. Solar energy will be accessible as long as we have the sun. Therefore, sunlight will be available to us for at least 5 billion years, when according to scientists, the sun is going to die. Next, it reduces our electricity bills. Since you will be meeting some of your energy needs with the electricity your solar system has generated, your energy bills will drop. How much you save on your bill will be dependent on the size of the solar system and its electricity or heat usage. Moreover, not only will you be the saving on the electricity bill, there is also a possibility to receive payments for the surplus energy that you export back to the grid. If you generate more electricity than you use, considering that your solar panel system is connected to the grid. Next, diverse applications. Solar energy can be used for diverse purposes. You can generate electricity, that is photovoltaics, through photovoltaics or heat solar thermals. Solar energy can be used to produce electricity in areas without access to the energy grid, to distill water in regions with limited clean water supplies, and to power satellites in space. Solar energy can also be integrated into the materials used for buildings. Not long ago, Sharp introduced transparent solar energy videos. And next advantage is that low maintenance cost. Solar energy systems generally don't require a lot of maintenance. You only need to keep them relatively clean, so cleaning them a couple of times per year will do the job. If in doubt, you can also always rely on specialized cleaning companies, which offers the service from about 25 to 35. Most reliable solar panel manufacturers offer 20 to 25 years warranty. Also, as there are no moving parts, there is no wear and tear. The inverter is usually the only part that needs to be changed after 5 to 10 years, because it is continuously working to convert solar energy into electricity and heat. Apart from the inverter, the cables also need maintenance to ensure your solar power system runs at maximum efficiency. So after covering the initial cost of the solar system, you can expect very little spending on maintenance and repair work. Now we will talk about disadvantages of solar energy. Okay, first is cost. The initial cost of purchasing a solar system is fairly high. This includes paying for solar panels, inverter, batteries, wiring, and for the installation. Nevertheless, solar technologies are constantly developing, so it is safe to assume that prices will go down in the future. Next is weather dependent. Although solar energy can still be collected during cloudy and rainy days, the efficiency of the solar system drops. Solar panels are dependent on sunlight to effectively gather solar energy. Therefore, a few cloudy rainy days can have a noticeable effect on the energy system. You should also take into account the solar energy cannot be collected during the night. On the other hand, if you also require your water heating solution to work at night or during winter time, thermodynamic panels are an alternative to consider. Solar energy storage is expensive. Solar energy has to be used right away, or it can be stored in large batteries. These batteries used in off-the-grid solar system can be charged during the day so that the energy is used at night. This is a good solution for using solar energy all day long, but it is also quite expensive. In most cases, it is smarter to just use solar energy during the day and take energy from the grid during the night. Luckily, your energy demand is usually higher during the day, so you can meet most of it with solar energy. It uses a lots of space. The more electricity you want to produce, the more solar panels you will need, as you want to collect as much sunlight as possible. But solar PV panels require a lot of space, and some roofs are not big enough to fit the number of solar panels that you would like to have. An alternative is to install some of the panels in your yard, but they need to have access to sunlight. If you don't have the space for all the panels that you wanted, you can opt for installing fewer to still satisfy some of your energy needs. Now, how does solar energy work? The sun releases photons. When the sunlight hits the PV cells of a solar panels, those photons knock loose electrons from atoms. The electron flow through a circuit via a conductor to generate electricity. The PV modules then produce a direct current DC, which is converted into alternating current AC by an inverter. Solar production is measured in watts, kilowatts, and kilowatts hours. Watts measures power, while kilowatt hours measure energy produced. The average solar panel ranges from 250 to 400 watts, and under proper condition generates about 1 kilowatt hour per day. Most solar panels wattage ranges from 250 to 400. Okay, for example, imagine if you have 5 300-watt solar panels and get 4 hours of peak sun hours each day. Multiply each panel's wattage by peak sunlight hours, which gives you a production of 1,200 watt hours per panel. Then divide by 1,000 to convert to kilowatt hours per panel, which is 1.2 kilowatt hour. Multiply by the number of the panels, you have to estimate the total amount of energy your solar array can produce per day, which is 5 kilowatt hour. Okay, now types of solar companies. Even the best alternative energy company usually aren't equipped to manufacture, install, and finance your solar energy system. Instead, many solar companies specialize in one or several of those areas. Homeowners mostly deal with installers and financing companies, but it's essential to understand how the different types of solar companies functions. Okay, solar panel manufacturers. Solar panel manufacturers create the solar cells and assemble the solar panels that go on your roof. Solar panel manufacturers are often at the forefront of solar energy research and development. The best solar panel manufacturers own their supply chain, assemble high efficiency solar panels from the cells they create, and offer long-term warranties on their products. Solar panel retailers. Retailers are the middleman between the manufacturer and the installer. Solar equipment retailers and distribution companies work with networks of suppliers, manufacturers, and contractors and installers. Solar installation companies. If you think about purchasing a solar energy system like buying a car, your installer is like the dealership. Usually, solar panel installers source panels from a manufacturer directly or through a solar panel wholesaler or retailer. A solar panel installer's primary business is getting solar panels working on your rooftop, which requires other components, including wiring or inverters. These companies can be small or large. Some serve only certain geographic areas, while others operate nationwide. Solar financing companies. These companies help people finance a solar panel system for their home through solar leases, loans, or power purchase. Okay, these are some of the solar companies. Okay, have a look. Terraform Power, Azure Power, Yingli, Urza Global Limited, Indo Solar, Solar Edge, Canadian Solar, Brookfield Renewable, Tesla Incorporation, Zinco Solar. Okay, this all about your this video. In this video, you have seen that I have talked about solar energy. What is solar energy? How does it work? How the solar energy is converted, convert the sun energy into a DC and AC currents, and how do we get the heat and light from it. Next, what are the advantages of solar energy, what is disadvantages, what are the types of solar companies which provide us this service. Okay, in this video I have tried to introduce every part related to solar energy. I hope you have liked it. Please do like and share, and please subscribe to my channel. Till then.